Well, hello. It is another beautiful, beautiful day that has not been promised to us. And because it has not been promised, we are going to take advantage of every hour, every minute, and every second that is available to us on today. How you doing? It is the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince, and welcome to another episode of the Mike Prince Show. Got a lot going on right now. Of course, basketball has just really got into the swing of things, but we still have a lot of important football left. We have two SWAC games this coming weekend. Traditionally, it was one, but due to Hurricane Harvey, we're going to have that Labor Day Classic. With that being said, could this be the beginning of a new trend? We'll talk a little bit about that later on. Got some scheduled guests. Hopefully, they'll be able to catch up and come through with us. Hopefully your Thanksgiving has been a fruitful, productive Thanksgiving as we get ready now to head into, it's official now that it is Christmas season. Black Friday and all that good stuff is kicked off and about. And so we are ready to try to make amends, if you will, for the Christmas season. As we may mention at the top of today's show, I want to remind you that you can also follow me on Twitter at Radio Guy. Instagram is Radio Guy 22. And don't forget, we have a 24-hour live stream that can be heard on TuneIn. All you have to do is go to Open Mic Broadcast Network, OPEN, capital MIC, Broadcast Network. And if you happen to be out and about and don't even want to use up your data, we got a remedy for that as well. All you have to do is dial this number, 605-477-5066. Lock that number in, and you're able to listen to our programming 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days of the year. It's just that simple. Lot going on. Congratulations to the Prairie View A&M University Panthers men's basketball team. Won the MGM basketball tournament that was held in Las Vegas, Nevada. They will regroup now to go to University of California, Santa Barbara on that West Coast swing. And so congratulations to Coach Byron Smith and company. We'll get into the basketball a little bit later on. We still have a lot to discuss in regards of the FCS, the FBS, even though we don't dig too deep into the FBS. A lot of people ask me, they say, well, Prince, why don't you talk more about the Big 12 and the SECs and the things of that nature? It's a simple, simple answer. Those conferences have more than their share of coverage, and there's no knock on them. But we figured that we could really, really make a difference and have a somewhat of an impact by being able to discuss and go into still some quality competitive sports on the FCS ranks in regards to the Mideastern Athletic Conference, Southwestern Athletic Conference, so even some of your D2 programs, so many different other areas of coverage that we figure, why keep trying to crowd yourself into a room that's already busting at the seams? And let's go into this big open space and grab all that can be grabbed, build a brand, create an identity, and create an interest. Because these guys are competing just as hard as the other ones. And I know when it comes to X's and O's and dollars and cents and everything, people have a tendency to want to gravitate to the big boys. But we really, really feel that this is part of our mission, for lack of a better word, lack of a better description. It is a duty for us to go out and make these things happen. And we take all the pride, the honor, and the professionalism that it takes to carry these off, because it is something that is very beneficial. We get it all the time from the coaches, from the institutions that we deal with, and we're going to continue to do what we do, how we do. We do local and regional high school collegiate coverage. We cover high school area, JUCO high school, I mean JUCO college levels. We cover the Southwestern Athletic Conference, the Mideastern Athletic Conference, FCS programs. We do cover and keep up with the Southland Conference. The Southland Conference is a neighboring conference that is right within the realm of what Prairie View and other SWAC schools are competing at and on. So we embrace all of these guys. We are finding a whole bunch of exciting, dynamic ball players from the JUCO rank in the Region 14 area. So it's a lot of things that can be covered and have some substance and some valuable content. And that is the route that we have chosen to do here at the Open Mic Broadcast Network. With all that being said, we'll get straight into this weekend's football coverage. Give a congratulations to Alabama State Hornets with their victory over Edward Waters. I say that somewhat with loose tongue in cheek due to the fact that Edward Waters is a very, very small program compared to Alabama State. And it's just like with when Prairie View played Bacon and some of these other schools that they play, Virginia Commerce, I believe that's the name of the school that Mississippi Valley plays. And a lot of people say, well, why do you guys play them schools? Why do you all play those schools? Well, that's equivalent to one of our FCS programs going to play an FBS program. They know what should happen. It's a payday for the FCS program, an opportunity for some exposure, create a memory for those guys who are competing from those various programs on the FCS program. It's the same thing that the FCS offers up to your NAIA programs, to your D3 schools. So, you know, if it's good for the gander, it's good for the goose. But congratulations to the Hornets. They finished real strong, end up with a 5-6 overall record for the completion of the season. Was not enough to stop the release of Brian Jenkins mid-season. And so it's going to be interesting to see how the Hornets reload and adjust to look for a new coach. Will they stay with the interim coach, or will they go outside and look for it? It's one of those loaded gun deals when you're taking the interim coach and he's able to work some magic with these guys, and then you say, okay, maybe this is our guy, and you lock in. And the next thing you know, maybe there were some things that were missing that we wanted to add. So it's going to be interesting to see how Alabama State handles that. There's going to be interesting to see how the rest of these schools fill these vacancies that they have for their coaching jobs. We spoke with Lee Hall, who is the voice of the Mississippi Valley Delta Devils, and got some of his feedback on the Cummingy experiment and where they're going to go and how they should be going. But all that remains to be seen. Meanwhile, you have the Alabama A&M Bulldogs are going to be looking for a coach. The Hampton Pirates are going to be looking for a coach. The Florida A&M Rattlers, the Delaware State Hornets, University of Arkansas Pine Bluff, and at least for now, the word on the street is Hughes is safe at Jackson State. However, there will be some challenges and some adjustments to be made. They're going to have to get some new OCs and personnel adjustments to get everything going on. But we'll talk about that later on in the segment. We're going to see if we can get caught up with some football games that will be taken over the course of this weekend. In particular, you have the Prairie View A&M University Panthers and the Texas Southern Tigers putting a cap on their season by playing the Labor Day Classic extended version at BBVA Stadium this coming weekend. That kickoff will start at 6 p.m. 6 p.m. kickoff will be the last official regular season game for the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We'll try to catch up with the voice of the Tigers, Larry Chatterbox Hale. We'll try to catch up with him a little later on in the program. And we have the Southern Jaguars and the Grambling State Tigers doing battle at the Big Easy, the Bayou Classic. You have the East already set in the likes of Alcorn State. And a lot of people try to give Alcorn State grief that they're really not that good of a team. They just happen to be the beneficiary of being in the East, which is somewhat of the weaker division of the Southwest Athletic Conference. But I say all that to say they win the games they're supposed to win. They beat the opponents that they have scheduled in front of them. And when you're doing that, whether I'm in the East, West, North, or South, it does not matter. I'm taking care of the business that I need to take care of. And as long as I'm doing that, does it really even matter what anyone else is doing or saying? Not really. Because all I know is that when the record books reflect, it's going to say Eastern Division champions, four consecutive years, Alcorn State Braves. And that's better than what Texas Southern can say, Prairie View can say, Alabama State could say, University of Arkansas Pine Bluff, Mississippi Valley, Jackson State. Southern, for even that reason. They take care of the business that they're supposed to take care of. Some would say that they win ugly. I would choose to say that they win effectively. They have handled some schools. This last game of the regular season for them against Jackson State, they lose 7-3. A lot of people trying to read into that. I don't read into that. I look at that as Coach McNair giving his guys who don't normally get a chance to play, get some reps in, trying to avoid any major injuries leading into this SWAC championship game that'll be in Houston December 2nd at NRG Stadium. Why would I put all that on the line? You know, we have the East sewn up. It is a done deal. So why should I go out there trying to quiet my critics and prove them wrong by getting caught up in a spitting contest trying to show, well, we got game. Well, you got game. It shows you have game. You take care of business in the East, you know, which is one of the indications now that the championship game is being dissolved, at least as we know it right now. Would there really be a need for East in a West division when it comes to football? Would there really be a need for that? Or would there even be a need for East and West throughout all athletics? If we're going to eliminate the championship game, in my own personal opinion, there is no need for divisions. You could go ahead and just line them up, and whoever is the number one seed, they are the number one seed, cut and dry. They represent the SWAC in the Celebration Bowl. There's absolutely no reason to keep the divisions. You know, you can say this, that, or the other, but there is really no valid reason to keep it. You're going to have to go back and revamp the schedules. You know, right now you have it on this 7-game rotation. You go back to play every school. As we may mention, we have the Prairie View Texas Southern game that will be played on November 25th, 6 p.m. It will be the last official regular season SWAC game of the 2017 campaign. I've been joined now by the voice of the Tigers, none other than the great one himself, Larry Chatterbox Hale. How you doing this morning, my brother?
Well, Dr. Michael Prince, my frat brother, happy belated Thanksgiving to you. I'm doing great. Getting ready for this big football game on tomorrow as Texas Southern hosts the Panthers of Prairie A&M. I guess we could say for the Turkey Day Classic, I guess.
Sound like you having a little challenge with that, brother.
Good day to have a turkey drive, I guess, but to get up so we can boost up our community service hours. But the game will be played on Saturday. I think it'll be hopefully we have great weather. It'll be at 6 o'clock in the afternoon. And I just hope the Tiger fans and the Prairie View Panther Nation shows up and shows out for this event. It's an HBCU event like no other.
Absolutely. And when you talk about it, there has been a lot of concern on whether or not the fans would show up from both sides, being that both schools somewhat didn't have the projected seasons that they wanted, but it's still a rival game. Do you think that's going to have a cause and effect on the overall attendance?
It might. You have some fans in the city of Houston that might be interested to come out just because it's that time of the year. You got family in. They have family in from out of town. Who doesn't move? Actually, who's not a football fan in the state of Texas? I can count them on my hands. So I think this will be a very well-attended contest. I'm hoping, I got my fingers crossed, because we don't want them to miss nothing. I think this will be a very good game for the Panthers to showcase their talents and send their seniors out. And Texas Southern, we moved our senior night from the Southern game to this game to send our seniors out the right way. I think it's going to be a special group of individuals there that can really shed some light on this thing and bring a positive light to it. I just want as many people as they can to show up and watch these two Texas teams, HBCU classic teams, go at it.
We're talking right now with the voice of the Texas Southern Tigers, Larry Chatterbox Hale. The Panthers and the Tigers, due to Hurricane Harvey, have moved the Labor Day Classic. I've been calling it the Labor Day Classic extended version for the 2017 campaign to the final weekend of November. Of course, that somewhat has clashed with the Bayou Classic between Grambling and Southern. We'll talk about that a little bit later. With that being said, there's talk that Prairie View will be accepting the SWAC-MEAC Challenge for 2018, so they'll revisit and play this game later on down the year after Thanksgiving. And I don't have a problem with that, but I think it would be a bit more effective and even a bit being conscientious in respect to the Bayou Classic to try to set that game up on a Friday in the near future.
Well, I mean, like I said before, a lot of the folks who really want to support Southern and Grambling, they're going to do that. Folks who want to support Texas Southern can do that. I don't see where it's written on any of the back of any newspaper. I went through the State of Texas Hall of Records saying that four black college football teams can play on the same day. You know, with me, my Tiger pride, and you and your Panther pride, we don't want to take a backseat to anybody.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Of course, we might not be on NBC or things of that nature with the hype, but I think we got two of the best bands in the country. I think we've got two of the best set of fan bases and the fans when we really get at it in the country. So I just think if the fans and the administration get behind this like they will, I think this could be great. This could be something different other than just looking at Southern and Grambling. You look, get a chance to look at Texas Southern and Prairie View in a holiday type atmosphere.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. With the challenge for the Panthers this year, of course, Prairie View's Marching Storm led the charge for the Macy's Thanksgiving Parade, and I got to tip my hat, a job well done for the Marching Storm. There's going to be a push of acceleration to make sure that the band is in place for this weekend's game between the Tigers and the Panthers, which you may mention that's part of the lure, not just of the Texas Southern Prairie View game, but of black college football. The band is a very integral part of the overall football experience on an HBCU level. With that being said, as you mentioned, I don't have a problem with Prairie View playing their final game. But what I would like to see, if they're going to do that, that they stagger those games, kind of like they're doing this year, and stagger it, where you can get a little bit of both, if you understand what I'm saying. If I'm going to stay here in the Texas area and look at Prairie View, Texas Southern, I want to be able to kind of wink down the road and see what's going on. I might not be able to take in all in, but take in some of it and then go and enjoy my own game of choice.
I understand what you're saying. I think it'd be a good idea if they did do it on Friday. But just say they did do it on Friday this week, the Marching Storm wouldn't be able to make it.
Oh, no doubt.
I know. Yesterday for the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade.
Yeah, well, now we knew this was an exception to the rule, and I'm all for that. But I'm just talking about that could really create a great environment.
Turkey Day. So you're saying you want to have it on a Turkey Day Friday? That way, if folks want to go support Grambling and Southern, they can still ease on down the road a couple of miles down the way and see that game as well. I think that's a good idea.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, because look, man. After, say, for instance, we get done with our Prairie View Texas Southern game, you know, we do what we do, we say what we say, and we say, hey, man, let's take a road trip. You know what I mean? If we want to, or if I choose to stay in the luxury in the confines of my home and check it out, either way, I can do it. I think you give the fans that much more exposure. And you give you give the brand even that much more exposure to go ahead and take advantage of seeing both games.
I totally agree. I think we should make it accessible so that everyone gets to enjoy the black college football experience. I'm not going to even lie to you. I love sitting back and catching the leftovers and watching Grambling and Southern and going back to the refrigerator and taking a little nap and waking up when you hear the fans holler or something, holler a touchdown on television. That's exciting for me, because when you got a little ham and your little turkey in you, you get lazy. And that means I don't have to work. I can just sit back and watch TV and just keep working my microwave over and over again and watch some black college football. This is something new for me. I haven't done this in a while.
Yes, sir. It's been like 2005, 2006. That this was pushed back. I want to say Katrina was part of the reason.
Right. And when we did that, it wasn't a very good showing.
Right.
At the Red Lion, it wasn't a very good showing. Because the simple fact was, no, they had the Bayou Classic here, remember?
Yes,
because
sir.
Because they couldn't play it in New Orleans.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Absolutely.
They had our game one day, and then they had the Bayou Classic. Yeah, so I'm not sure how they're going to work that one out. I mean, that was, you know, I just hope that they come to a way that we can both, if we can both play both games and get the same kind of excitement, you know, because the Bayou Classic is going to be the Bayou Classic. Texas Southern and Prairie View is venturing into uncharted territories right now by playing this game on Thanksgiving weekend with having a chance to market and things of that nature. I'm really intrigued to how it will be attended next season and what day it'll be played on, because you have a whole year to prepare. The folks in Prairie View have a year to prepare to get their heads together as far as marketing this football game.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think that's going to be the key to it all. With this game, I think it's going to be a fairly better attended than what others are anticipating, due to the fact we knew that this game was going to be pushed back already. We knew that this was going to be pushed back. But to get the hype and the interest that you get for that Labor Day Classic, and part of the fact is with that Labor Day Classic, no one knows what either team has to present and offer to the table. So the excitement of the unknown has always been a drawing factor. But in the same breath, go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, in the same breath, I think it's a bit added anxiety to both coaches, and a bit unfair, because a game of this magnitude emotionally and predicating on where you are in the season, to make this your first game coming out the gate, that's some pressure, brother. That is some absolute added pressure. They might not want to admit to it, but your season is almost laid out before you in the past on how you responded to this Labor Day Classic.
Yeah, and Coach Mike Haywood went out and did something about that. We scheduled a game before the Labor Day Classic. We get Florida A&M, but shoot, when you think of it, we lost two defensive linemen right out of the gate. First half of the ball game, we lost them, and we lost another player. So we wound up getting beat up in that game against the Rattlers of Florida A&M.
Yes, sir.
We were young, and we're still a young football team, playing a lot of redshirt freshmen. We're going with the youth movement right now. So, I mean, you know, you kind of take a deep breath and say, ooh, glad we kind of pushed that game back a bit. Glad we had a chance to get two wins under our belt. Hell, look what's happened to us. We've gone through two quarterbacks since Florida A&M. We lost Jay Kristoff to an injury. We lost Dominique Galera to an injury. We're playing a true freshman and Elijah Odom. So, wow, funny how the tables turn in this situation as far as rescheduling and things of that nature.
Talking
and most
right
of this
now.
Time of the year, man, everybody that's playing ball is really kind of beat up right now anyway with Nixon, stuff like that.
Yes, sir. We're talking right now with the voice of the Tigers, Larry Chatterbox Hale, and you got right into it, Chatter. The Tigers have been having a growing pain season this year. You may mention playing a lot of a freshman. What has the attitude and the atmosphere been like in Tiger Nation?
Well, the attitude as far as the fans are concerned?
As far as the fans and the players.
Well, sometimes, you know, you have to be particular about what you wish for. If you want someone to build a program, you know it's going to be growing pains. If you want a quick fix, here today, gone tomorrow, you got to be careful about that too. Rome wasn't built in a day, as Sam Cooke was saying. I think Coach Haywood wants to build a football program, regardless of what others may think, regardless of what other people did. We're in the process of right now of trying to build a strong foundation. And with building a strong foundation takes patience. This is Mike Haywood's second year. You wanted him to recruit Houston. He's recruiting Houston. You wanted him to get some players to build around. He's got that. But you just have to be patient and let him get other players in here to help these young kids, and which he's going to do. We have 14 scholarships available. He mentioned that on the coach's show. We have 14 scholarships available. We're going to go out and use those on junior college transfers to bring in some experience for these young Tigers. And I just think that I can see it happening each and every week. Every snap, things are different. These kids are growing up. And when you say you're not a freshman anymore, but you got to look at it, you kind of still are, because you just went to the prom in April. You just walked the stage in June, and now you're asked to lead a football team as a starter. You're asked to play against juniors and seniors. You're asked to play against grad transfers. So, yeah, this is a very young football team, and, you know, but these kids give it their all each and every week. They play hard. They play tough. I think they played a great game against Mississippi Valley State. Elijah Odom showed me some things. The emergence of Brad Woodard. There's a big bad Brad Woodard sighting again. He ran for some great yardage along with Tyler Cook. Didn't do a lot in the air. But this is still a very young football team with a true freshman as a quarterback. So we got to see what happens.
So let me ask you this, Chatter. Has Tiger Nation got impatient?
You hear a little rumbling every now and then of why we can't win. But, you know, when they catch the right person to the side tonight and people explain it to them, then they understand. This is not a team that's loaded with a lot of upperclassmen. You look at Southern's roster. Southern is loaded with upperclassmen. Why? Because they had some things in place to help these young kids. Like I tell them, Rome wasn't built in a day. You want the quick fix? It might be a problem. We had a quick fix back a while back. Got all the way to the championship, and you see where that got us. So you just have to trust the process. You got to trust the people that you put in place. Trust your AD. Trust your head football coach. Trust his coaching staff. To make this a great situation. Later on, you're going to forget about all those lopsided wins we had with these youth because we're young. But once we do what we need to do and we grow up, these Tigers are going to be something to see.
Talking with the voice of the Texas Southern Tigers, Larry Chatterbox Hale, just cutting it plain simple. You know, hey, you got a young squad. And with that being said, you got a young squad that's going to be taking on this experience, this
juggernaut,
atmosphere.
A juggernaut in Prairie View. It's loaded with Nico Hollins.
Hey, Nico Hollins is a redshirt freshman.
Hey, look, don't try to, look.
You know what? I've been waiting on this. Here's the real Chatterbox. Here's the real Chatter. He coming out the box now.
Don't try to tell me you baked the turkey when you deep fried the turkey. I know what it tastes like. I know what honey baked ham tastes like, Mike Prince.
Hey.
Michael Prince.
Hey, look now. This is what I've been waiting on. I was like, this is a very somber Chatterbox, and I'm liking this, but I say, he about to rise up, and then he's talking about the juggernaut. Nico Hollins.
Juggernaut in Prairie View.
Nico Hollins is a redshirt freshman who has proven and has earned the right to lead this Panther squad. He has earned that right, and he is taking advantage of the opportunities, and he's on fire right now. He has 18 touchdowns on the season. Are you still there, Chad?
Juggernaut.
He said juggernaut. It's okay. It's okay. So am I hearing that you've conceded already, or you just
not at all.
Oh, okay.
By no means. As long as I've got tiger power running through my veins and the hair stand up on the back of my neck, whenever I hear the school song,
yes,
hell
sir.
Hell no, I'm not conceding. You won't get that phone call from me. You might get it from Ronald Reagan. You might get it from Gerald Ford, but you won't get it from me.
We won't get it from the Chatter.
Long as I got Phi Beta Sigma Blue.
What you say?
Across my chest, you'll never get it. Tigers don't quit. There's no quitting me.
Yes, sir. So you're not going to stop saying, put your hand on the radio, we need some Tiger Power.
No, not by a long shot.
This is the Tiger that I was looking for. This is the Chatter that I was looking for. And they say, bring it on. You know, that is a lost art, man. A lot of people don't know how to take the smack nor give the smack, and they take the stuff personal. You can never take the stuff personal, but it's called pride. It's
right,
called.
But you have to understand the situation you're up against in order to give it the right way.
Of course.
It's like we're a young team. We know that, but we got a lot of swag to us.
Uh-huh.
And we're not going to back down. These are some Tigers that are not going to back down. Went toe-to-toe with Grambling and Grambling. Came out on the wrong end of the scoreboard. Went toe-to-toe with Southern. Well, these guys are not afraid.
Well, you know what? I say about not being afraid, though? And I love it. You know, I like whipping on somebody that wasn't afraid. That means it was a good fight.
That's right.
You know,
knows what can happen on Saturday once this football is kicked off? Who knows what can happen?
Well, now, we do understand, you know, that the rival game is a rival game. You can throw out the records. You can throw out the youth. You can throw out the inexperience. You can throw out whatever little adjective you want to put in front of that on an excuse on why a team shouldn't perform. But
let me ask you this.
Yes, sir.
Do you think Nico Hollins knows about the rivalry? He's a young kid. Do you think Elijah Odom, that quarterback, a freshman, knows about the rivalry? No. They know about football. They know they play for Prairie View. They know they play for Texas Southern. They know we are 50 miles away from each other. So we know. They know in their own way how big this football game is. You don't have to drop one of your fancy doctoral presentations to get them to grab it, Doc. They know.
So you don't even have to hype this one up.
No.
You don't have to hype this one up.
They hear the radio commercials. They know.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And they hear the reminders throughout the course of the year. Don't forget to take care of business down the road.
You got to get Prairie View.
Pardon me?
You know you got to get Prairie View.
Right.
You know you got to get TSU.
I don't care if it's Tiddlywinks. I don't care if it's hopscotch. We got to take care of Texas Southern. That's just the nature of the beast. And that's what makes this thing beautiful. And that's why I think it could survive being played on the Thanksgiving weekend if it's strategically placed in the right order. I really do. I really do. And going back to the NRG experience, NRG is just too massive of a place, in my own personal opinion, that it does not do and give the draw that we think. I mean, yes, Prairie View, Texas Southern is huge, but to fill a 70,000-seat stadium, that's asking an awful lot. But to fill a 22,000-seat stadium at BBVA, to fill 15,000 at Prairie View, that's not asking too much. That's very doable, very achievable. And I think once this thing is placed and locked into its position, if this is what they're going to do, if this is the day they're going to do it on, and you start building toward that new trend, I believe you're going to have something very magical, very regardless of the records.
Right.
Regardless of it. But going back to that, I don't want to hear no excuses after Saturday.
What?
I don't want to hear no excuses after Saturday.
Oh, you won't hear any? I just don't want you changing number on me.
No, brother, I haven't had this same number for 20 years.
Don't send me the voicemail. Don't do none of that.
We're talking with Larry Chatterbox Hale, the undying love and adoration he has for his Texas Southern Tigers. And those that follow the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince, you know what I feel about my PV. But one thing that ties us together is he got a little soul on his end, and I got a little soul on this end. And together we able to stomach each other through the course of these games. Now, getting back That's to right. some real nuts and bolts, brother, what do you think will be some key factors for you guys to pull this game out?
We have to control the football. Texas Southern has to control the football. We've got to control the clock. We've got to control the time of possession. We have to block for Elijah Odom. No matter what we're doing, that offensive line, the battle has to be won in the trenches. Texas Southern has got to do a better job of blocking the defensive front for Prairie View A&M. Our wide receivers have to step up and catch the football when we throw it their way. Malik Webb, Ladell Blair, Mario Smalls. This is his last time playing as a Texas Southern Tiger. So you've got to step up to the challenge, hit the time clock, and go to work.
Well, you got it right there from the Chatterbox, Larry Hale. The Panthers and the Tigers doing battle for the Labor Day Classic extended version, which could be the precursor of the Turkey Bowl, Southern style, from BVBA Stadium. Chatter, it's always a joy to catch up with you, my brother. I know you got things to do, X's and O's to figure out, you know, and then I got a special Phi Beta Sigma handkerchief for you after the game so you can wipe them tears away when PV come out with this victory. How about that, my brother? Oh, man. You know I love you, right, brother?
Of course, I love you too. That don't stop.
You know, so. Phi Beta
Sigma. Sigma's got so.
P-H-I, a B-E-T-A, a S-I-G-M-A.
Phi Beta, you know, Sigma got
so.
Oh, don't get me going with that bass in here, boy.
Oh, man, look here, man. Well, look here, one love to you, brother. And to God be the glory, pray that no one gets hurt. But in all, let the games begin. Larry the Chatterbox Hale, I am the radio guy, Dr. Mike Prince. We're going to take us a break, and we'll be right back.